Peoples, it's your girl Tasha. I'm coming to you with another album review. Today we're going to talk about Mary Mary's Something Big. Let's get into this. So on March 29th, Mary Mary did release their sixth studio album entitled Something Big. To me, I think it was well received. According to the Billboard charts, it's sitting at number 2 on the gospel album chart. It's sitting at number 7 on the R&B and hip-hop albums chart. And it's also sandwiched in between Rihanna and Justin Bieber at number 22 on the Billboard 200. I think that's pretty good. People like Rihanna, people like Justin Bieber. It's good to be in the middle of that sandwich in mind. Okay, so a lot of people aren't feeling this album. They're just not feeling Mary Mary as a whole. Like, they're still holding on to this whole, they're too secular, they're too worldly. You know, everything that they're trying to do is not for the kingdom of God. They're just trying to edify themselves and be mixed in with the world. I can see some of that and some of the things that they do. Not a whole lot. That was probably my main reason why I did not purchase their last album, The Sound. Because I was like, for real, David Banner, I mean, it's not like I've seen too many times where he goes around screaming Jesus, nor does his lifestyle screams I'm serving Christ. But you know, I did purchase that song off of iTunes. I will have to say that I do like that song. But you know, I just kind of see, and then with the whole getting Amber Rose and Kanye West to be in your video for God and Me, that was just a bit much. It was taking it too far, and I think you were trying to extend an olive branch to these celebrities who really, their lives are not screaming Jesus, but you're trying to get them on the winning side and they're just not taking the bait. And I think that's kind of where things went awry with Mary Mary. And it turned out bad on their behalf. You know, I think they were trying to do something good, reach out to the celebrities who, you know, may not be saved, or, you know, who say they worship Christ, but their lives aren't really good. I think it backfired a little bit. And that's why people aren't feeling them, you know, when this album rolled around. But after purchasing and listening to this album for about 3 weeks, I think this is a great album. I really think it's a redemptive album. It, to me, it's kind of hard to listen to this album and then say, no, this is not Christ-centered. No, this is not going to help me with my walk with Christ. I mean, what do you people want? Really, what do you want from Mary Mary? What do you want them to say? What do you want them to do to make it so that you feel like they're worthy enough to call themselves Christians? I like this album. I don't like, you know, a lot of traditional sounding gospel music. I like stuff that's contemporary. I like stuff that's urbanized. That's the key word everybody wants to use. Urban, you know, music. I like that stuff. I listen to Christian rap. So to me, this was a great album. I think there are some really good elements on here that Mary Mary have stuck out with throughout their career. I mean, when they released their first album in 2000, this is what they were about. They weren't coming out to, I don't think they were really trying to come out and say, oh, we're just your, you know, plain old, same, traditional sounding, never gonna change Christians. No, they were bringing something new even in 2000. I think we just didn't recognize it. It went about, let's see, what album was that? The album before The Sound, not that Christmas album, but the one right before that, I think it's called Incredible or something like that. That album, I think, kind of made people change a little bit, because even their sound started changing a little bit. They were getting played on urban radio, you know, mainstream networks and stuff. BET was bringing them on 106 and Park and stuff like that. So I think people kind of shied away from them when they went there. But I think Mary Mary's, their mission, their theme has been the same throughout. And it's really... Okay, now talking about some of the tracks on the album, it's kind of hard for me to pick one of my favorites because I kind of like them all. But what I would do is, if I had the control, I would rearrange some of the tracks. So, because there are some tracks that I want to hear before I hear some of the other tracks. You know, like some of the, like Something Bigger. I also like It Is Well, Blind, Survive, Are You Ready, Catch Me. Oh, what's the other one that I really like? Oh, Sitting With Me. Sitting With Me, I really do like that one as well too. So I would probably put those like at the beginning of the album, and then the rest can trickle on down. Of course, Mary Mary not wanting to be, you know, out of touch with what the world is doing and what music is doing right now, they do have a techno Europop dance track on here. It is called Never Wave My Flag, so I like that song. They're keeping up with the trend there, and that's fine. Okay, everybody's doing it. Everybody in the secular gospel world is doing it, and now gospel people are doing it too. I love it all. Keep it coming. All of the songs are really good. I mean, I think there's something here for everybody. I'm not understanding, like I said earlier, why everybody is so, they're not Christian enough. I guess I'm not Christian enough. That's what I'm gonna say. If Mary is not Christian enough for you, then I'm not Christian enough either. Don't judge us, just pray for us, and if we're wrong, then God will move in our lives and let us know, but don't be sitting here judging people and thinking that you're holier than they are, and that's not how you minister, and that's not how do you edify the kingdom of God doing that. Okay guys, so yeah, I think you should go out and purchase this album if you have not already. I'm gonna give this album a 4 out of 5 stars, only because I can't say that I like this better than Kirk Franklin's Hello Fear, but I can't say that I like Hello Fear better than Something Big. To me, they're on the same level. They're really good albums. Both of these albums, in respect to gospel music and respect to what people are saying about Kirk Franklin and Mary, that they're too worldly, they're too secular. I think both of these albums have come back, and I think that Mary and Kirk Franklin have listened to what you guys have had to say, and so they are re-examining their lives and re-examining what they're doing in music. But at the same time, they're not going to let your comments like that stifle what they're doing and where they want to go with their music. I mean, this is how they support themselves, so we should be happy that they're able to do stuff like this and support themselves, because as gospel music artists, we don't get the shine and the credit like Rihanna and Justin Bieber do, So I say stick with it, gospel people. Do what you need to do. Stay humble. Stay focused on God. And, just let God bring your light out, and people are going to see that in the end, okay? So go buy the album. It's really good. It's out in stores now. Wherever you buy music, go buy it. I gave it a 4 stars. Let's see if there's anything else I can say. Okay, guys, so that's the end of my review for Mary's Something Big. You guys drop your comments below. Let me know what your favorite tracks are. How are you feeling about the controversy surrounding them? Are they too worldly? Do they do enough for the Christian movement? How you feel about it, okay? Thumbs up this video if you like it. Share it on Facebook and Twitter. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. And let me know what the next album that you're ready to purchase, okay? I'm waiting until May. I think there are a couple albums that have come out here in April, but I can't wait for May. March was a great, great, great month for gospel music. May 2011 is going to be another great month to take us right on into summer with gospel music. I will come back and tell you guys about that. We're going to do a gospel stool reviews, okay? So stay tuned. I love you. God loves you. Jesus can save. I'll see y'all in the next review. Bye.